He's the head of People+ AI. He's one of the most plugged in people in the AI, in the AI landscape. He deeply understands tech, he understands investing, he understands entrepreneurship and policy like nobody else. He'll be doing a deeper dive on the strategy of how India can maximize the potential of AI. Let's give a warm welcome to Tanuj Bhojwani.
Namaskara, Bangalore. Thank you so much for coming here. Thank you so much for that introduction, Bala. It's deeply kind of you. I have a lot of ground to cover today. I'm going to try my best to do it. I've been told to speak slowly. I've been told that my clock speed usually is a little too fast. So tell me if I'm going off track. People+ AI, Shankar gave that introduction, but essentially, every time a new technology comes into play, you have this problem that we end up, if you don't pay attention, in a future by default, where humanity is shaped by technology. Fancy words, what do I mean? I actually mean this, that if you want to start a restaurant today, Thai restaurant, your best bet is to call it Thai food namely, because that's how you get to a restaurant. You Google, this is the best for SEO you could do. If you want to go to some, you know, far away place and get that picture posing like that up there, you have to stand in what's called the social media queue. It's really funny, right? Like all of us acknowledge that we all want that picture to go post that we want to be in solitude. And so we all cooperate to stand in the line so that we can take pictures one by one. This is humanity shaped by technology. But what if you could live in a world of a future by design, where technology is shaped by humanity, where we get it to do what we want? What does that world look like? And how do we get there? So this event obviously is about such a technology, is AI. And I'll just go, if you know me, I always want to get to the nub of things, right? And I'm going to address this straight up front. Is building AI in India hard? Are we going to see companies out of here, models out of here? Are we going to see actual AI innovation out of here? I know a lot of you are skeptical, right? So the question on the screen is AI in India hard? The answer is yes, right? I'm not going to lie. It is hard. But it's not A, impossible. B, you just have to look at it a little differently. And I'm hoping that I can show you what we see at People+ AI. So your classical view of AI is this. AI is data, compute, models. And for all three in India, we have it hard. Correct? Yeah? 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 I disagree. Right? I think that India will be, let me start by putting my neck on the line, putting myself out there and say, India will be the AI use case capital of the world. And if you have to hold me to account, by the end of this decade, right? So, 1st January 2031, I promise you, this will be true. And we'll talk about how. So let me present to you this vision, this future, where India is the AI use case capital of the world. And we call it an Adbhut India, little AI pun of our own. So the argument for an Adbhut India is actually very simple. Number one, India needs AI. We have a lot of problems, right? You take any sector, you take any developmental goal, we're not as far along as we should be. This needs to change. I hope everybody agrees with that, right? Like there is a set of problems that needs to change. But then, it's also specific things about our country. For example, language, right? If two Indians were to randomly meet on the street, so the census also notes what languages people speak. On average in India, people speak 2-point-something languages. If you take all the people in India, and the census has recorded every language that they have, so you randomly pick a person, see the two languages they speak, and randomly pick another person, and pick, see the 2-3 languages they speak, the chances that you'll hit on an overlap is only some 34%. Right? So we can't even talk to each other without translation. Right? Literacy rates in India, officially, are 3 in 4, right? 77%, so it's roughly 3 in 4. It means 1 in 4 people can't read or write. And that's also again, what is the bar for literacy, right? Like, what point do you say that they can't read or write? There's all these things that because of which we need AI, right? And second, India is ready for AI. Now, compared to, say, Europe or anywhere else in the West, we are much younger. We are younger by a head and a half, right? So the average age in Europe is 44, and India is 28. We are young, but we are also connected as compared to, say, places like Africa, right? We have a lot more smartphones here, a lot more people online. And of course, you know, like Bala has to pitch plug for my book, No Pressure. I also want to tell you that we have DPIs, right? It seems awkward to come on stage and say it. But India has this digital infrastructure that has allowed us to do some wondrous things in the past. I mean, of course, all of you know UPI, but even the little things, right? DigiLocker, DigiYatra, these things that sort of make our lives easy. And then recently, as compared to when I first started up in 2011, I would say that the VC and startup ecosystem, and a lot of, I saw some of my VC friends here, that's become amazing too. We are genuinely are the world's third largest and third best, if I may say so, startup ecosystem, if not second. And this one's a little different, right? Which AI needs India. It's that to take a company like Google, which has more free cash lying around than the GDP of half of the other countries in the world, and they still charge you $20 a month to use Gemini Pro. Because the fundamental fact that AI is expensive, right? It's very, very expensive to run. So when you put these three things together, right, demand exists in India. People want a technology that will improve their lives. But it's latent. It's not coming out because there's no way to, like, for me to go and say, boss, give me this, right? That thing doesn't exist for them to demand it. Second, supply exists but needs to be activated. You all need to stop thinking that this can't happen in India. And third, the business model of the tech world is going to move from attention to transaction. Because, like I said, AI is expensive. So when you put it all together, what I'm trying to say is that India is structurally different from the West. So AI in India will look structurally different from the West, right? But we're just a few innovations away from Adbhut India. We can get there easily if we try. So I'm going to talk about how I think we can get there. So now let's go back and reframe that picture. I and my kin from colleges like IIT are guilty of making these things seem way more complex than they actually are, right? Or AI is data, model, compute. Actually, it's a lot of math, right? It's a lot of multiplication, to be specific. The data is what you multiply. The model is how you multiply. And the multipliers, which are expensive, are, you know, the compute or the GPUs or everything else. But there is, this picture usually misses two things, right? One is the talent. Who decide what to use all those three, right? Like, how do you design those three? And finally, the use case, which is whom does it serve? Why are you going and multiplying all these things so much, right? And when you put those together, you see that actually what AI is these five things. And here I believe that India's AI strategy should be use case led. Like I said earlier, we have a lot of problems, a lot of things to solve. We have a lot of people who want access to things that they've not had. If I today took away Google from you and said, pay me $20 a month to use search again, to go find information again, you would pay me, right? There's a bunch of people in India who've not been introduced to that concept of computing, to that access to that information in a manner that they can consume it. If you were to give it to them, I do believe they'll pay. They won't pay a lot, they can't pay $20 a month, but they would pay it, right? And therefore, I believe that if we have our use case-led design, we can come down to very specific kinds of AI, which are smaller models, you know, and sort of easier to deploy, you know what you're doing, it's a narrower use case. As opposed to say, where the West is aiming with AGI and going towards, as Nandan put it in Sutra's GTS in December, my model bigger than yours was, right? We can be focused on whom it's serving and come up with something. And then India's AI strategy should be use case led, but also DPI enabled, right? We've cracked this. We've cracked how to do population scale solutions. We found success in multiple diverse areas. Thank you, Pramod. And so therefore, why would we not apply the same thinking and the same logic to AI, right? And if you do that, you come up with these six ideas. I won't dive into this, I'm running out of time. So it is my contention that AI is stacked for Bharat, right? We can get this right. And it's not just me who thinks that. Your badges. We asked you a simple question during registration. What's your dream for 2030? What do you think, what do you hope AI will solve? What change do you think? So all of you gave answers. We wrote the answers in the back and we made a picture based on the prompt you gave, which we've given to you, and also a little postcard, if you have it, which is like personalized to your prompt. But also here are some, right? Like Sahana thinks that AI has taken over manual scavenging, and we can, right? And we should. So it's not just me who believes that by 2030 we can have this, it's also all of you. But the truth is we can't do this alone, right? If it takes a village to raise a kid, it takes a nation to raise a population. And we're hoping, and this is why we're here today, that we can extend an invitation, a silly pun again, to invite you to co-create this Adbhut India with us. And if you want to do that, we just have four principles that we hope you will align on, right? Be use case led, be collaborative, it's too large a problem to do alone. Build and share public goods, but also a responsible future. So this is what People+ AI does at the end of the day to achieve that Adbhut India future. Four things. One, use cases. Two, infrastructure to make those use cases go to population scale. Three, build a community. Most of the times I'm stealing ideas from all of you, but first we have to create that space and put it all together so that that can even happen. And four, celebrate good ideas coming out of India. Celebrate good thoughts, good startups, successes coming out of India. Outside in that space, we try to put as many facts, not just about ourselves, but about other people and other startups who are doing things. We put together a talking painting to show how Indian startups and Indian technologies have come together to build that. And that's what we hope to continue to do, right? Just put other people ahead and show you that this skepticism about India is unwarranted. And this is who we are. We are a small team that helps you do big things. So if anything you do fits in that vision of Adbhut India, do let us know how we can help you. Because if there is one thing we genuinely believe, right, it's that AI won't change the world, right? It's not some technology that is godlike that's going to do everything. You will change the world, right? All the choices you make from here on decide what if India and when India becomes an Adbhut India.